Now, student, let's learn the next topic, changing the desktop background. You enjoy working with Windows as it is user-friendly. You can change the appearance of the desktop background according to your choice in the following way. Right-click anywhere on the desktop and click. The moment you will do right-click, you will get this options. Okay, can you see these options? You will get this thing. Then you need to click on personalize. Okay, the moment you will click on personalize, you will get personalized dialog box. The moment you will click on personalize option, you will get personalization dialog box will appear. This kind of screen you can get it. Can you see? Now click on the desktop background. Okay, you can choose any of the, see here, you can see this desktop background is written. You need to click over here. Okay, the moment you will click on personalize, click on desktop background, you will get this screen. A new window with multiple images will appear. See, you have different images, you can see different pictures. This screen you will get it. Okay, you need to select any background from the display list. You are getting all these pictures, huh? You need to select any of this. Okay, then automatic a preview of the selected background will appear on the monitor. Okay, getting? After selecting the background, click on the save changes button and close the dialog box. You can see save changes option is there. You can click over there and close this dialog box. Okay, and by this you can able to change the desktop background. So let's go through this slide once again for changing the desktop background. I am not going to tell anything, you just need to read line by line of the desktop. Okay, you need to see this, you have to learn this. Okay, start doing that. Now I will show you by changing my own desktop background. See, as of now you can see window logo is there, correct? Now let's change the background. So what we need to do, right click over here, go to personalize, then you can see this, can you see this screen? Then we need to go down desktop background, can you able to see me? Then click on desktop background. The moment you will click on desktop background, you are getting all this. Now which one I should select, which one I like this scenery, then click on save changes. Now see, got getting me? It's looking nice. So you can change your background whenever you want to change it. Okay, shall I change once again to the Windows one? I like Windows more. So I am going to desktop background, I am selecting my Windows, save changes, and now again I am getting my Windows back. Okay, so my desktop screen is again back. Clear? Now let's see what else we have. Changing the screensaver. Okay, changing the screensaver means the screensaver is an image, is a picture, okay? Like this, it's a picture which pops up on the computer screen whenever a computer is left idle for a certain period of time. If you leave your computer without doing anything, that time is known as idle time. By pressing any key or moving the mouse, you can again get back to the normal screen. Follow the given steps to change the screensaver. Okay, we will now see what all these steps are there to change the screensaver. If you are not touching the computer, still few images will come, few pictures will keep on coming. That is your screensaver. So let's see how to do that. So first step, right click on the blank area of the desktop. The first thing you need to right click on the blank area of the desktop. Then click on the personalize option from the shortcut menu. You can see over the shortcut menu you need to click on personalize button. Okay, personalize option. Clear? The moment you will click on personalize option, you will get personalization dialog box will appear. This dialog box will appear. Okay? Then after you are getting personalization dialog box, then click on the screensaver option. You can see screensaver option is here. The screensaver setting dialog box will appear then. After that you will get the screensaver dialog box. This, the screensaver setting dialog box will appear. Can you see this? Okay. Getting? Now click on the drop down arrow in the screensaver section and select the screensaver of your choice. See how? You need to click over here, drop down arrow, and in this screensaver section you can select any of the screensaver of your choice. Okay, getting me? You need to click over here, then out of this options you can select any one of that. Okay? The moment you will click over there, a mini preview of the screensaver will appear, will display in the preview box. To watch the preview on full screen, click on the preview button, wait for a few seconds and you will get the preview of the selected screensaver on the full screen. Okay? Let's see how it is. See, a mini preview of the screensaver. To watch the preview on the full screen, you need to see. Wait for a few seconds. See how bubbles are coming. Move the mouse to come back on the screensaver. Now, let me show you how to do it. Okay? Now, I am doing for my system. First, what are the steps? First thing, I have to right click, then go to personalize, then I will get this dialog box. Okay, you can see this window will appear, personalize dialog box will appear. Then go to screensaver, now click on down arrow, whatever you want. Like first, let's start with 3D text, go to preview then, the moment you will go, you can see this way. Now what else? Blank. Now see the preview, you will get blank screen. What else we have? Bubbles. You can see like this. Then photos. You can see photos like this. Okay? Then ribbons. So whichever you like, you can use that one. Okay? Getting? And then click on OK button and you can see your screensaver. Clear? Hope it is very much clear. Now let's see what are desktop gadgets. Windows contains mini programs called gadgets which offer information at a glance and provide easy access to the frequently used tools. Windows 7 containing gadgets like calendar, clock, CPU meter, currency, weather, feed, headlines, slideshow, picture puzzles, window media, center WinZip gadgets. Okay, now let's see what are these gadgets. Now right click, you can see gadget option is here. Can you see? Click over there. You can see calendar, clock, CPU meter, currency, feed headlines, picture puzzles, slideshows, weather and window media. If suppose now on my screen there is no clock, correct? If I want a clock, what I will do? I will click on this.